Dismantling America's history, that is the subject of tonight's Waters Words. President Trump said this on the heels of the Charlottesville attack, which began over the removal of a Robert E. Lee statue, the famous Confederate Army general.
This week it's Robert E. Lee. I noticed that Stonewall Jackson's coming down. I wonder, is it George Washington next week, and is it Thomas Jefferson the week after? You know, you really do have to ask yourself, where does it stop?
Waters World personally believes statues of Confederate war heroes are a part of our nation's history and can serve as important relics to reflect upon. But they are also very divisive, and localities should vote on whether or not they should be removed. Leave it up to the people. What I don't like are radicals ripping statues down, as you can see here. Destroying historical monuments is what the Taliban does, not American citizens. Let's also remember that all of these Confederate war heroes were Democrats. Democrats were the party of slavery. Maybe the left wants to tear down these statues so the country forgets that the Democratic Party enslaved black people. But I actually think many on the left want to destroy any monument of revered historical American leaders. Vice News tweeted this article: "Let's blow up Mount Rushmore." A bust of Abraham Lincoln in Chicago was torched, and he was the one who freed the slaves. And Chicago is in the land of Lincoln. Open a history book. Liberal analyst Angela Rye on CNN said this:
George Washington was a slave owner, and we need to call slave owners out for what they are. Whether we think they were protecting American freedom or not, he wasn't protecting my freedom. I wasn't someone who, my ancestors weren't deemed human beings to him. And so to me, I don't care if it's a George Washington statue or a Thomas Jefferson statue or a Robert E. Lee statue. They all need to come down.
Angela, it's one thing to remove a statue of Robert E. Lee. He was known only for fighting to maintain slavery in the South. George Washington and Thomas Jefferson were primarily known because they wrote the Declaration of Independence, defeated the British, and founded the country. Because they owned slaves at the time, as many others did, does not define who they are. And George Washington's a bad guy now, so we're going to have to rename the Capitol? Can't call it Washington, D.C.? And then there's the Washington Redskins. I always thought it was the Redskins part that was offensive. Not Washington. Then there's Al Sharpton, who said this about the Jefferson Memorial.
When you look at the fact that public monuments are supported by public funds, you're asking me to subsidize the insult
of
my
family. Thomas Jefferson had slaves.
And I would repeat that the public should not be paying to uphold somebody who has had that kind of background.
We finally found something that Al Sharpton doesn't want to spend taxpayer money on. And why would Al Sharpton care where his taxes go? Doesn't he still owe the IRS about $1 million? And finally, Nancy Pelosi chimes in and says she wants the Confederate statues in the U.S. Capitol removed. Ms. Pelosi has been in Congress for 30 years. Now she speaks up? What took you so long, Nancy? And I don't recall Nancy wanting to remove the statue in the Capitol of former KKK member and Democratic Senator Robert Byrd. I guess that has to come down too.